today along with my partners, Dr. Bunny, Professor Z, and Dr. Ryu, we are going to introduce to you what radioisotopes are.
Okay, first, we need to break down the words. The words radio and isotopes. From the words radioisotopes, however, the word radio refers to radioactive. Now, what does radioactive mean?
First of all matter in the universe is composed of atoms, from trees to atomic fragments. These atoms combine to form the different elements of nature. However, occasionally an atom may become stable. When this occurs, the atom will emit energy or particles called ionizing or nuclear radiation in an effort to become more stable.
Hence, radiation is energy or particles emitted from unstable atoms, and radioactive materials is any materials that emits radiation as it decays.
Now, what is an isotope?
An isotope is each of two or more forms of the same element, contain equal numbers of protons but different numbers of neutrons in their nuclei, and hence differ in relative atomic mass, but not in chemical properties. In particular, a radioactive form of an element.
Well said, Professor Ash. Now let's combine the words and see what a radioisotope means. Professor Z?
Radioisotope is an atom where the nucleus decays spontaneously, giving off particles and energy.
The decay leads to a change in the number of photons. It transforms the atom to an atom of a different element.
Sum it up, where there's an imbalance between photons and neutrons, it's an unstable isotope. Usually when the ratio of neutrons to protons is too low, the isotope will want to transform itself into a more stable form of a different atom.
When this happens, the atom will decrease its mass by ejecting part of its nucleus. It is a spontaneous process that is known as radioactive decay. There are three main types of radioactive decay.
The first type is alpha decay. It occurs when the atom ejects a particle from the nucleus. Both the atomic number and mass decreases.
The second one is beta decay. It occurs when a neutron is turned into a proton and an electron is emitted from the nucleus. The atomic number increases and the mass slightly decreases.
And the final is gamma decay. It occurs when there is a residual energy in the nucleus following either alpha or beta decay. The residual energy is released as a photon of gamma radiation. It generally does not affect the atomic number or mass.
Many radioisotopes are naturally occurring, formed by the interaction of cosmic rays with the molecules in the atmosphere. Tritium is an example.
Sun radioisotopes were formed millions of years ago and continue to be present in our environment. Take uranium as an example.
Radioisotopes are produced as a byproduct of nuclear reactors and by radioisotope generators such as cyclotrons. Many man-made radioisotopes are used in the fields of nuclear medicine, biochemistry, the manufacturing industry, and agriculture.
So to sum up what a radioisotope is, it is any chemical element that is unstable in the nucleus. This causes the radioactive material to decay and emit radiation.
You're right, Professor Z, but a simpler definition we could give would be the radioisotopes are radioactive forms of elements. The isotopes, because they differ in the number of neutrons and the naturally occurring elements.
That's all for now. I hope our introduction to radioisotopes was informative and useful. Till the next time we meet fellow chemists, over and out.